So let's look at the three components that went into creating our page, which was our glue controller file, our routing.yaml file, and our hook menu. And we'll start by looking at our controller. So if we go back to our file browser, we can find our glue controller in lib Drupal glue controller. And let's open this up to take a look again. So this is the first time that we've run into objects or classes in this video series. And even though the code doesn't look very long here, there's a lot of new elements to explore if you're not familiar with object-oriented programming. We'll come back to this and explore it in some detail in a little bit, but let's look briefly through the code. So at the very top, we define a namespace, and we're going to spend a good amount of time talking about namespaces in just a little bit, so we'll skip over talking about the real role of this line. Next, we define a class. The class is called glueController. Notice that it has the same name as the file, glueController.php. And then we have one method in this class called helloWorldPage. Now, if you're new to object-oriented programming, a method is just a function inside of a class. This uses the public keyword, which we'll also talk about more, but it basically makes this function available outside of the class itself. And finally, this function simply returns a render array. And just like we did in our hook page alter, we added a markup item, and we're just passing it some content, hello world. So this class, as we're looking at it now, is responsible for building up the content that eventually gets rendered to the page. Now there are some nuances to the idea of a controller that you'll start to understand as the videos progress, but for now it's fairly clear to see that the output here is what we're seeing on our page in the browser. Okay, so we still haven't seen why the URL that we go to ends up getting sent this content. So the next thing we want to look at is our routing configuration.